Hey, morning, Kristen. We're doing a special little thing. Let's see how this looks. We got back the edits from the Mind Mage's Wrath from book two. So I'm going to, I don't want to spend a, I don't want to, I'm not going to dive off of first draft to work on it, but I do want to go through like a chapter or two. And I think that'll be fun. So we're going to do that really quick. Yay, edits. Wait a minute, what? Oh, balls. Morning, Clooney man. Is it scratching my microphone? Really? Sorry. Nope. Hello again, Clundy. Sorry for the buffer. It's not my fault. Oh, am I on your TV? Sandra. Did anybody see today's epic rap battle of history? George R. R. Martin versus J.R.R. Tolkien? Pretty good. Not the best. I don't know. I feel like the rap battles these days just kind of aren't as good as some of the old ones. This one was pretty good. Sometimes they put one out and I'm just like, that's not good. Who thought that was good enough to put on your YouTube channel? But that one it was good. It was competent. Hello, Sandra. Again. My favorite epic rap battle is actually a more recent one. It was Batman versus Sherlock Holmes. It was amazing. It was incredible. Are you serious? Oh my God. That was my growl. Hello. Thank you, Jesus. So in case I just realized I have not explained at all what I'm doing. So in case you're wondering what the hell I'm doing, I am trying to see how ellipses are formatted in Lord of the Rings and whatnot. Son of a. You're telling me there's no ellipses in the Lord of the Rings? I do not believe this. It's pretty good, isn't it, Kristen? If anybody can point me to an example of an ellipsis in the Lord of the Rings, my kingdom. What the hell? All right, maybe I should just skip this. Really? Well, hell, let me find that. This is my favorite passage in all of the Lord of the Rings. Or this is my favorite, this is my favorite passage in all of Lord of the Rings, by the way. Special little treat for you VlogaNovelin Lillians thingy. At the hill's foot, Frodo found Aragorn, standing still and silent as a tree. But in his hand was a small golden bloom of Elenor, and a light was in his eyes. He was wrapped in some fair memory, and as Frodo looked at him, he knew that he beheld things as they once had been in this same place. For the grim years were removed from the face of Aragorn, and he seemed clothed in white, a young lord tall and fair, and he spoke words in the elvish tongue to one whom Frodo could not see. Arwen van Imelda Namarie, he said, and then he drew a breath, and returning out of his thought, he looked at Frodo and smiled. Here is the heart of Elvendom on earth, he said, and here my heart dwells ever, unless there be a light beyond the dark roads that we still must tread, you and I. Come with me. And taking Frodo's hand in his, he left the hill of Cairn Amroth and came there never again as a living man. Which is like a really blatant example of omnipotent narrator, like telling you he came there never again as a living man. But holy shit, I get chills every time I hear that. It's incredible. The first five pages of The Two Towers is one ellipsis after another? I do not see any ellipses. I think you are lying to me, Kristen. Well, whoever said that fucking lied. There are no ellipses whatsoever. All right, I'm gonna go with my first decision and skip this for now. Yay for wine. Every great family has some dark deeds to their name. She's great, isn't she? All right, we're going to finish chapter 5 and then we're going to get back to our first draft. I like Karen a lot. I know, it drives me crazy. Well, honestly, she gets it because of the style sheet, and like here, then isn't really being used as a conjunction. I mean, it kind of is, but it's not a conjunction that's being expected to hold together two independent clauses, which is or even like a long dependent clause and an independent clause. So I get what she's saying. Like she read my style. She knows. So that's why I'm just mentioning. If it's permissible the way that it is, I'd prefer to leave it because, just 'cause. Ba 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 ba. Good one. I know. Okay. Oh, God. Why? Mm-hmm. Ah. Okay. Yeah. No, I'm happy with this. We're gonna go through it again. We're gonna do some more thorough editing and all that sort of thing, but no, this is good. Okay, I'm gonna go refill my coffee. I'll be right back. Okay. There it is. In the middle of the darkest night, in the middle of the blackest night, I would find you here, in the puddle of the bravest tears. Being enough to know it's lonely where you nothing matters but the pain when you're alone. Never any nights when you're awake. To the edge of this lost world, we have marched and we have sworn to a painted crown of thorns. As the hungry days unfold. We wait for morning to consume. We are. You are for Ah. Spielbergs and Kubricks. It's our time to make a move. It's our time. Lysol. Open up the skylines and count the drums. Ways I could show you that. But you don't really see yourself that high up. Say something, I'm giving up on you. I'll be the one you want me to. Say something, I'm giving up on you. Saying goodbye. Seriously? God damn it. Okay. Haha. I have to end the stream. We have gardeners coming over to trim one of our trees. Well, we did 1,156 words in a half hour, and we should be able to return before long. We're going to take care of the gardeners. That's really annoying. Ooh, distractions. Yeah, we're going to take care of the gardeners, and then I'm having lunch with a friend from out of town, and then I will return. I shall be back. Yeah. Thanks for coming and hanging out, Kristen. Haha. thanks for coming and hanging out, Kristen, Sandra, and Clundyman. And wasn't somebody else here? No, just you guys. Awesome. Well, I'll be back later in the afternoon, theoretically. Somewhere around 2 or 3, probably. All right. No, 3, I have a phone call. Ha. Okay. Talk to you guys later.